When the NBC News team visited the residential area, angry residents of Narraville's Extension 7 have organized themselves after they received information that the second victim of COVID-19 will be buried in the evening. As officials from the Ministry of Health arrived in the area for burial, the procession was disrupted and blocked by the angry residents. When the vehicle carrying the body made a U-turn, the residents proceeded to the newly identified graveyard and filled up the grave that was meant for the burial. They vowed to guard the area throughout the night to ensure that no burial would be taking place. The defiant protesters argued that they were not consulted or informed that the site close to their houses would be used as a cemetery for COVID-19 victims. However, tension continued this morning when the residents arrived as early as 6 o'clock at the site in big numbers. This came after they received information that the health officials would return this morning to proceed with the burial. The defiant crowd remained adamant that they will ensure that no burial will be happening under their watch. Erongo Governor Neville Andre visited the site this afternoon to address the residents.
It is not a cemetery here. When the cemeteries are full, you must do your studies. But here is not a cemetery. We will not allow people to be buried here. We have a burial committee, and this burial committee was supposed to engage the community on what is going to take place here. I would take the blame for not informing the community.
They also complained about what they termed inhuman burials. For now, no burial will be taking place at this site until the two parties have reached an agreement. Timo Andreas, NBC News, Valve, Spain.